Hello and welcome to ATP Report. It's the Katie and Barry Show, and joining me direct from London, England, and live, Katie Hopkins. Hi, Katie.
Hi, lovely. How are you doing?
Terrific day to talk about the crazy American political landscape. Let's start with the big news that is sweeping America, and I know you're keeping up with it from your side of the pond. The Attorney General in Texas, Ken Patton, has filed a landmark lawsuit alleging that the swing states in the United States took away the rights of the Texas citizens by unilaterally changing law regarding the election and doing it illegally. So he sued on behalf of the state of Texas, Pennsylvania, Michigan, Georgia, and Wisconsin, attempting to invalidate the election results. So six states have joined as co-plaintiffs. 11 other states are asking to join in filing amicus briefs or friends of the court. Mm-hmm. President Trump has requested to join the lawsuit. And news just breaking, I think there's another state coming in. Katie, what do you think of our goofball American political system and the lawsuit?
I love it. I tell you, I'm in such a good mood. I'm excited for this lawsuit. I'm excited for the level of support it has in terms of Republicans. I'm excited for the attorney generals that are going with this. So people that are joining this fight, it makes me feel like the loyalty for Trump is still there.
Well, he has a unique political argument, which is these various states, the swing states, exploited the COVID-19 pandemic by illegally changing the election procedures in violation of federal and state law. So the gist of the lawsuit is that only the legislatures in every state can set the rules. And in all of these swing states, the swing states that when we went to bed on election night were very heavily in Trump's favor, and by the following day had all flipped the other way, illegally changed their laws by bypassing the state legislative process, and either the courts or the head of elections or the secretary of state, well, they just changed the rules. So hundreds of thousands, if not millions of extra ballots came in. And the concept is that the rights of the people in the states that voted properly were eliminated or overruled by the illegal voting. What do you think the chances are of success? I know you're not an attorney, but as a layman, what's your take?
Yeah, and I think your last point there, that was something it took me a while to kind of work out. At a Supreme Court level, this becomes a sort of almost adjudication, doesn't it, between was it unfair on states that voted correctly according to the rule book, that almost their vote is discredited by these states that didn't vote according to the rule book. So it's a sort of case about protecting the democracy in states that did vote according to the rule book. I tell you, I'm excited about it, and I'm excited about it as well because the media are going to so much length to discredit it immediately. And yet the numbers of people stacking up behind Trump, the GOP with him, the state reps that are with him, makes me feel like, and the fact that Trump has come in saying, this is the big one, this is the one, I'm feeling really optimistic. Maybe that's blind optimism, maybe it's hope over reality, but it makes me feel like there is still hope, and that's something important, I think.
Yeah, and you know, ironically, the nomination of the last justice, Amy Coney Barrett, to the court may be the swing vote.
Yes.
The court is sometimes looked at as a 6-3 court, other times as a 5-4 court, because Chief Justice Roberts, who was appointed by George Bush, who was supposedly a conservative, has mellowed over the years and tends to go to the other side. So it may come down to a 5-4 vote. Wouldn't that be ironic if the deciding factor was the last justice who got appointed?
You know as well, don't you, that if there are any signs that this could be successful, one of the first indicators will be the boarding up of stores again. The boarding up, those boards that go up immediately when, you know, like we saw when we thought we were going to get the Trump win that was voted for, the boards were up. And of course, the minute Biden's team get what they want, fraudulently or otherwise, the boards come down. You know very well, if this goes to the Supreme Court, those boards are going back up, or when it hits the Supreme Court. I also think at the moment, I think they're also requesting a delay, aren't they, of for the 14th of December. They're trying to push that back.
Well, yeah, and the deadline really isn't till January, Katie, when the Electoral Yes. College actually votes. So there is a bit of time, and this is not unlike 2000, although the roles are reversed. In that case, the Republican ended up getting the victory, and things may absolutely turn around if the Supreme Court does intervene. What's interesting in our country is that the press is unanimously dumping on this whole process. Newsweek, which used to be the most popular news magazine when it was still in print in the United States on a weekly basis, ran a story yesterday on the Texas case. And I read the story and tried to be just an objective reader who didn't know what he was reading about. And I got to the point after the first page that this is the stupidest, most frivolous lawsuit in American history. It's a political stunt. It's a waste of money. And if you didn't know any of the story, you would think Ken Patton, the attorney general in Texas, ought to resign immediately because he's a flipping idiot. There was not one positive message in the entire article that the suit had any merit whatsoever, in spite of the fact that now 17 states and the White House have all joined in. What's the press like over there?
And that's exactly it. I printed off this evening the names of all of the GOP that are going with this. And that makes me realize just how many people are going with this and makes me feel positive and optimistic. But as you rightly say, if you go anywhere near the media, and it's the same, I mean, if not worse, in Europe, because you haven't even got the grassroots shouting about how excited they are. The European media is just vile. Der Spiegel, which is one of, you know, the largest weeklies in Europe, they've just had a picture of Trump on the front where they call him essentially the fire devil, and they're accusing him of torching his own country. You know, bear in mind that's in Germany, where Angela Merkel allowed the migrant, Muslim migrant hordes in, and it has effectively decimated Europe, or certainly Christianity out of Europe. You know, the hypocrisy knows no bounds, but you cannot get a positive news story on Trump in Europe.
Well, you think that's a bizarre story. What's going to happen if on Inauguration Day, it's Biden being inaugurated? Everybody over here is talking about what's Trump going to do. I guess it's a rumor that Trump is going to have an alternative thing for people to watch, which is a huge Trump rally at which he will announce, I'm back in 2024, and he's going to spend the next 4 years, as you and I have talked about, being the opposition outside of government, yelling across the Pennsylvania Avenue fence at the White House, and saying, 3 more years, 2 more years, 1 more year, I'm back. What do you make of that day?
I'm so excited for it, Barry, I can't tell you. My brain is already working out, how do I get there? Where's it gonna be? You know, what's the detail? I'm dying to get the scoop on it. And funnily enough, my husband and I were supposed to go away on that weekend. And I'm like, no, I don't think we can. I have to be wherever Trump is announcing 2024, and that Trump rally is gonna be immense. Where's it going to be? Well, he'll do it in DC, surely.
Nobody knows. I mean, the big question is, what's the Supreme Court going to do? So, final question on the subject, Katie. If the court decides to intervene, right now they're looking at briefs from both sides, the states that oppose the motion from Texas and the states that support the motion to intervene. If the court intervenes and sets aside the electoral selections in Arizona, Georgia, Pennsylvania, Michigan, and Wisconsin, how will America react?
You know what, Barry? I believe it's a necessary thing. Because right now, 70% plus, you could call that 80, 90% of Republicans do not accept the Biden win. And so I almost believe it needs the Supreme Court to take this case and to adjudicate, because that's the only way I think there's going to be some sort of resolution to this. Republicans are always going to believe Trump won, but the Supreme Court does need to intervene. And for me and for so many people, I think it will just be the most joyous moment, because we believe in democracy as well. Our side believes in democracy. And all we want is for every legal vote to be respected. So this media line that this is anti-democratic, no. Fraudulent elections are anti-democratic. All we want, all Americans want, is democracy. And that's what this is about.
Well said, Counselor. I approve of your political analysis, and I hope you're right, honestly. Thanks for joining us today on ATP Report with Katie and Barry. Katie, thanks for coming on again.
Thank you.
For those of you that don't know how to get our daily alerts, please text the word TRUTH, T-R-U-T-H, and send it on your cell phone to 88202, push send. You'll be automatically subscribed to our free text message alert system. Or you can go to our website, americantruthproject.org, and sign up there, especially if you're overseas. Our text message won't get to you in the UK, but our emails will, and you'll be able to watch every show. For Katie and for me, Barry Nussbaum, thanks for joining us on ATP Report.